Considering bariatric surgery is a significant decision. It requires lifelong changes in your eating habits, your food choices, your activity level, because you have to remember that the habits you go into surgery with are still the same habits that you come out with, and now is the time to prepare. And it can be challenging, but there are lots of tools available to help you. One of those tools is keeping food records. So when you come to the bariatric program, you are required to meet with a registered dietitian. Some of the things that you can expect to discuss are things like specific food choices, your pattern of eating, how often you're eating. And again, keeping those food records helps you learn about that. The main reason why we keep food records is because it creates awareness. Awareness, again, into our pattern of eating and our food choices. And once we have that awareness, that's what creates behavior change. And we know that keeping food records is the most effective means for long-term weight maintenance.
I found the tracking difficult at times to fit into my day, but it was really important to see the calories that I was taking in and to see the quality of the food that I was eating. So I found the tracking helpful.
So when you come to the bariatric clinic, again, we'll go over how to do that. Whether you keep paper food records, that's perfectly fine, or there's lots of available online tools for you or apps that you can use to help you. And again, we can discuss those options. So in terms of the food records, I always kind of make this analogy kind of like money. You know, we have so many calories to use every day, but how do we know how we're using those calories, or how do we know how to manage that budget, just like money, until we learn what all those foods cost you every day? And once we learn that, that's what creates behavior change. And so in addition to just keeping food records, you will be required to weigh and measure all of your food portions. So I do ask that you get things like measuring cups, measuring spoons, and even a food scale. So I will ask that you purchase a food scale so that we can record our foods accurately. And even after surgery, that will become very important, especially when we're looking at getting every single gram of protein in. Some of the other things that you can expect to discuss are some specific food changes. So we will talk specifically about weaning off of caffeine, alcohol, and carbonated beverages. There's no alcohol recommended for the first year after surgery. And even when you can consume some, it can be a significant amount of calories in the diet. Carbonated beverages. We ask that you are free of carbonated beverages before you're approved for surgery. Think about it. Putting bubbly beverages of any kind into that little small pouch can really be quite painful after surgery. Caffeine. Caffeine is not recommended for the first sort of short-term period after surgery. So for some people, it can take quite a while to wean off of that. So we do ask that you start doing that as soon as you start the bariatric program. And for some people, those caffeinated beverages do come with a lot of calories as well. And speaking of that, I do ask that you wean off of sugar in your diet. And it's funny, when we talk about sugar at the clinic, most people often associate it with things like ice cream and chocolate and our usual things. But actually what I typically see are a lot of liquid calories. So sugar sources from things like fancy coffees, juices, all of those things. And we keep our food records. Quite often people don't think of their beverages in terms of their overall intake, but it does contribute. So I will ask that you wean off of sugar in our food form and as well as your liquid calories. And those are some of the main things. The other thing that we will discuss, like I mentioned earlier, is your pattern of eating. So common patterns that I see are people will often meal skip. So they may skip a breakfast, perhaps have a lunch, and then a lot of calories at the end of the day. Or sometimes they graze all day long. And those are also valuable things that we learn from our food records. So we'll talk about getting into a regular pattern of eating. Even before surgery, when we're trying to lose some weight, eating regularly kind of helps that body use that fuel a lot better. But then it will become really important after surgery, because eventually you'll be able to consume about a cup of food at one time on average. So think about it. We can't be skipping breakfast, lunch, and then trying to put all of it in at one meal and trying to meet all of our nutrient needs in that one meal. We just can't do it that way. So we'll talk about your pattern of eating. looking at pre-planning meals, making sure that we're into three meals per day and maybe a snack or two if we need it. So those are some of the things we'll discuss. Some of the most critical things that we will also review when you come in terms of preparation for surgery are your eating techniques, and we'll talk about it lots so that you're well prepared. But one of the most critical things that people need to do to work on or start practicing in order to prepare for surgery is taking 20 to 30 minutes to eat their meal and chew every bite to a liquid consistency. And that is very challenging. Because think about it, right now you've got a good sized stomach, right? So we've got lots of ability to churn that food, break that food down. But when your stomach then becomes considerably smaller, we have less ability to break down that food and digest food. So it is absolutely critical that you take that time to chew your food and slow down your eating. Not to mention, even before surgery, when we slow down our eating, we actually get a feeling of fullness much sooner, and then we tend to eat less. So good for weight loss and really good for your preparation for after surgery. There's lots of tools that can help you do that. Slow down your eating, take small bites. I've got a baby spoon here. Believe it or not, this has been one of the most effective tools for patients to help them take small bites, fill that pouch very slowly, and slow down their eating. So that's something to try.
There's one thing in the program that they teach you, and that is to chew, chew, chew. So, so for 6 months in the program, you're practicing and you're chewing, and because that's, at the time, you don't realize how big that can be until after surgery. And then you realize, yeah, the chewing is a must. And so when I can't tolerate those solid meats, it reminds me quickly to chew, and then it gets easier and it gets better. Practice that chewing. Even though you think it's not important, you'll find out after surgery that it's vital.
The other thing we'll discuss is not drinking with your meals. Hydration is really important after surgery, but we have to do it kind of differently. Because think about it, eventually when you have about one cup capacity in your stomach, there's no room to eat and drink at the same time. So I'll be asking you to stop drinking 30 minutes before your meal, and then you can start again 30 minutes after your meal. But there's basically no space to do those two things together. So we'll talk about slowing down your drinking as well. Not drinking with meals, not gulping back water. That's challenging for people too, but after surgery, when you've got that really small space in the stomach, you can't gulp back water. You have to slow everything down, whether it be chewing, small bites, and how you're drinking. So we'll talk about some of those things when you come, but there are things that you can do to start to prepare. So again, we just discussed some of the things you can expect. Keeping food records, pre-planning your meals, not drinking with your meals, starting to slow down and chewing your food, weighing and measuring your food so that your food records are really accurate. Those are things that we will discuss when you come to the clinic. They are things that you will need to do when you're in the pre-surgical program to prepare for surgery. But the good thing is, if you're considering bariatric surgery, you can start all of these things now. I'd encourage you to start doing some food records. Even if you just start writing foods down and when you're eating, it starts to create some awareness. Start thinking about using smaller plates to help control portions, really taking your time to eat. Because then, when you come to the bariatric program, you'll just be one step ahead.